I still do stand-up.
You
still, do?
Do
you?
I do. I haven't done it in a while because I have two shows right now because it's a lot on me.
Yeah, yeah.
But I will get back to it very shortly.
That's what I just do. I just do a weekend in Vegas. I do the Mirage.
Yeah.
I do it every like.
You never had stage fright, did you?
Yeah, I mean, yeah. You still get a little.
You get the spilkers when you get out there.
Yeah, I get the spilkers. Is that? That's a Jewish term, right?
Yeah, the spilkers, like right. You know, agita.
You get it for different. It's a different level, but even though they're there to see me and they're paying to see me, you still, yeah, you get a little bit of the butterflies, you know, but you know that it's kind of a better setup than when you were an unknown doing a corporate gig.
Oh.
And who the hell knew?
The days when you have to make your bones are horrible. What was your worst gig? You remember it?
I don't remember. I mean, there's so many bad ones, but there are. But the weirdest one I remember was they wanted me to do a college, and they picked me up at, you know, the Improv or somewhere. They took me upstate, not far, but wherever. And it was a talent. It was like a talent night. I was the comic, and I was waiting in the dressing room. And these were the acts that were waiting to go on. And it was a guy in a California raisin suit, and nobody was saying it. He couldn't say anything because he's in the suit. Yeah, and a woman, a German woman, didn't speak English, with a monkey on her shoulder.
Oh.
And it was just us sitting there. Yes. And I was middling. I think the monkey was closing.
The
yeah.
headliner.
Yeah. I said, well, I guess this is show business.
Those
you
are
know?
The hard days. I once followed a guy who was speaking about the Holocaust, and now the comedy of Joy Behar.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you always have those stories. Yeah, they put on the video of something horrible.
Yeah, and Auschwitz, and now you. I mean, come on.
Yeah, yeah. I remember doing a cruise ship. Did you do cruise ships?
Oh yeah, I've done the cruise ships.
Those are kind of scary because you're.
Well, they could throw you overboard if you bomb.
But also,
I mean,
you're
it's tricky.
You're stuck with the audience for the rest of the week.
That's true.
Yes.
Right.
So I remember doing a show on a cruise ship, and it did not go well. And walking back to my room later, and you know they're so narrow the hallways, and I hear you know the hallway was turning, and I hear from around the turn, where do they get these comics? Come on, get somebody with some talent. And he turns, and it's me, and it's so narrow we have to shimmy past each other like this, you know. And I'm just like looking down.
All right. You know. One time I did a cruise ship, and this was many years ago, and I heard somebody say, how can they afford to get Bette Midler on this boat? Hey, Raymond, thanks so much.
Good to be here.
You have something else to tell me before we go? You want to say something else?
Can I plug the show?
Sure.
When is this going to air?
We don't know
yet.
Yeah,
it's not going to air.
Right? It is going to air. Yes, it is. Yeah. This was not just flapping
June 1, Men of a Certain Age. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Yeah,
well,
yeah.
Thank you for
good
joining
to see you.
Me.
Yes.
That was the lovely Ray Romano. And we'll be right back.
Really? Is this like an appearance?
Yes.
This is great. This is the best kind because I didn't have time.